Another alleged irregularity in the Filipino overseas voting process surfaces. The Philippine Embassy in Wellington urges Filipino voters in New Zealand who receive ballots that allegedly have a missing candidate's name to return these to their office. Allegations have circulated online of a supposed ballot that did not include Vice President Lenny Robredo in for the choices as president. In a statement, the embassy says the ballots with alleged missing entry should be sent to them so that the claim can be verified. It adds they are committed to upholding the integrity of the elections and stand by their oaths as public servants. Foreign Affairs Undersecretary Brigido Dulay, meanwhile, calls the issue fake news, insisting the Philippine Elections Commission has verified that all ballots in New Zealand have the complete lineup of candidates. The overseas absentee voting for the 2022 polls has been facing several issues, including delays in the shipping of election materials and allegations of pre-shaded ballots.
With just 2 weeks before the election, some voters here in the Philippines are unable to verify whether they can be able to cast their ballots come May 9. Now, some say they did not find their names on the COMELEC's online precinct finder, despite having participated during the last presidential elections. There were others who were learned of their inactive voter status, while some of the deceased relatives were still on the category of active voters. But the COMELEC explains the list was based on the 2019 elections and not from the 2016 national polls.
Back to mother ko, na ilang elections na, mahigit dalawang elections na before, siyempre, hindi siya bumoboto. So, bakit active pa rin yung status niya?
Medyo disappointed kasi meron lang tayong 6 years usually na to make a change for our country as an individual and also siyempre as for the community rin. Tapos ito yung malalaman mo.
Ang nagsusumiti sa amin ng listahan kung sino dapat tanggalin o hindi dapat tanggalin, kung sino dapat i-activate, i-deactivate o reactivate, ay ang local COMELEC. Dalawang magkasunod na election po yon. Dalawang magkasunod na election. Ibig sabihin po 2018 at saka 2019. Pag hindi po kayo nakaboto sa dalawang magkasunod na election na yon, deactivated po kayo at wala na pong paraan para ma-reactivate ang ating pong registration. Sa susunod na lang po after ng botohan na ito.
The poll body also encourages eligible voters who are not verified in the online records to reach out to the nearest COMELEC local office.
Kung saan nandiyan yung inyong presinto at the same time, yung do's and don'ts ng pagboto at the same time, nandun din po yung mga kandidato, listahan ng kandidato, national and local.
Those having problems with COMELEC's online voter verifier can send an email to itd@comelec.gov.ph.
COMELEC is hoping to complete its probe on the issues that caused the postponement of its final presidential and vice presidential debates this week. The event was supposed to take place this past weekend, but had to be moved to April 30 and May 1. Sofitel, which served as the venue for the COMELEC's debate series, pulled out in the last minute after the poll body's partner and event organizer allegedly failed to settle its financial obligations and issued them balancing checks.
Hindi pa pwedeng palampasin lamang ng ganun-ganun. Dahil nga, sabi ni Sir Christian, to a certain extent, tama naman po yan, napahiya din naman ang kahit paano ang Commission on Election dito sa bagay na ito. Deserve ng mga Pilipino, lalo na sa ganitong klaseng proseso, lalo sa election, alam po nila dapat yung nangyayari. We have to be very, very transparent. That is the least that we can do, at least as far as the Commission on Election is concerned.
Moving on, it's the Robredo-Pangilinan tandem all the way for the Liberal Party. That's according to Party Vice Chair and Senate Minority Leader Franklin Drilon. He insists the unity talks initiated by their camp have already ended. Drilon made the statement amid claims of other presidential bets that they were still being convinced to bow out of the race. The senator also dismissed the possibility of eventually ending up with a Lenny-Tito Soto tandem. Although he admitted asking the Senate President and Vice Presidential candidate about his plans after Soto's running mate, Panfilo Lacson, parted ways with his party, Partido Reforma.
Now here's our Sunday brief on the campaign. The famous food strip of Maguindanao in Quezon City turned pink on Sunday as thousands of supporters of Vice President Robredo and Senator Francis Pangilinan gathered for a concert. The event was held a day after the tandem's mammoth campaign rally in Pasay, which was attended by an estimated 400,000 ordinary people and celebrities as well. Only Pangilinan was able to attend the concert in Maguindanao, which was the birthplace of the community pantry movement during the height of the COVID lockdowns. An advocate of food security, Pangilinan said government must help such pantries instead of red tagging them. The Unity in Tandem of Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. and Sara Duterte Carpio also continued campaigning in the National Capital Region. They held a jam-packed rally in Taguig on Sunday, even though Marcos only placed second here in the 2016 vice presidential race next to former Senator Alan Peter Cayetano. Marcos's wife and three sons joined him in the sortie. Presidential candidate and labor leader Leody de Guzman, meanwhile, met with farmers in Rizal to discuss their land-grabbing woes. This comes just about a week after de Guzman's camp was gunned down when they joined an indigenous tribe protesting to retrieve their ancestral land back in Bukidnon province.
In other news, four people were hurt after a bomb exploded inside a bus they were riding in Parang Town in Maguindanao on Sunday. According to the regional police director of the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao, passengers were having breakfast during a stopover when the blast occurred. Authorities found that an improvised explosive device had been planted in the bus, which was on its way to Dipolog City from General Santos City. The four injured passengers have been sent to hospitals and are still undergoing treatment. Police are now checking CCTV surveillance footage from the area to see who among the passengers of the bus disappeared shortly before the explosion. While they have yet to determine the motive behind the explosion, authorities said they are looking into possible extortion attempts. The explosion occurred just a few meters away from the BARM's police regional headquarters.
A group of local basketball legends expressing support for the presidential bid of Vice President Lenny Robredo. The group, known as Basketball Icons for Lenny, includes PBA legends Olsen Masela, Johnny Abarrientos, and Jojo Lastimosa, as well as coaches Yeng Giao and Chot Reyes. In a video posted online, they urged voters to stand up for the last 2 minutes and back Robredo, as they vouched for her track record, who they praised for showing up in tough times.
Sa basketball, hindi pwedeng pa-absent-absent kapag may training o laban. Dapat laging present. You show up in the most difficult time.
Sa basketball, hindi ka pwedeng sumuko, laban lang ng laban. Kahit na pinipilit kang i-foul out ng kalaban.
Kaya naman bilib kami kay Lenny Robredo.